The Philippines' supply of Pfizer doses from the vaccine-sharing facility COVAX is set to go to indigent Filipinos. That's according to Malacanang spokesman Harry Roque. He says this is in compliance with the policy of COVAX where its vaccines go to the most vulnerable. He also notes that the president wants the vaccine distributed in communities where uptake is low and not in malls. Hundreds of people swarmed to malls this week in hopes of getting the American-made vaccine. The Philippines expects to receive a second shipment of 2.2 million more Pfizer doses from COVAX this month. New tests conducted by BioNTech show the COVID-19 vaccine it developed with Pfizer is still highly effective against the India variant. The preliminary studies had shown that the B.1.617 variant spreads more easily, with some evidence showing it may be able to evade some protections provided by existing vaccines. BioNTech says when the blood of vaccinated people was exposed to the variant, 25 to 30% fewer antibodies were detected. This suggests protection is a bit lower, but still at 70 to 75%. The Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine is around 95% effective against the original version of the virus. President Rodrigo Duterte issues a directive meant to prevent crowding at vaccination centers. But as Adrian Ayelin tells us, the order not to announce vaccine brands in advance is not sitting well with some Metro Manila mayors.
On the first day of the rollout of Pfizer vaccines against COVID-19 in Marikina City, residents were extremely satisfied they were inoculated with their preferred brand.
It's my own health, which is at stake, diba? So, parang privilege ko to choose my own vaccine. Kasi health ko yung concern ko above anything else.
Only 5,400 doses of Pfizer vaccines were allocated to the city government, but Mayor Marcy Teodoro stressed the importance of respecting the rights of individuals to choose their vaccine brand.
Informed consent ang hinihingi natin para dun sa medical eligibility. Paano kung yung bakunang gagamitin sa kanya ay hindi akma dun sa comorbidities na meron siya o hindi tama dun sa kanyang medical condition. Kaya nga, bago pa isaksak yung bakuna ulit, pinapaliwanag ulit kung anong produkto, kung anong epekto nito doon sa taong tatanggap nito.
Former National Task Force Against COVID-19 advisor Dr. Tony Liachon also believes that it is a basic right to be allowed to choose a brand of vaccine amid success stories in Western countries, especially against emerging variants of the coronavirus. Liachon initially favored the decision of President Rodrigo Duterte, who balked at the idea of allowing the public to pick their preferred jabs, arguing that it delays the achievement of herd immunity and causes health protocol violations. Duterte's decision for local government units not to announce the vaccine brand comes after people crowded a recent vaccination rollout where a Western-made vaccine was made available. The palace further argues all brands are effective against COVID-19.
So, lahat naman po ng bakuna ay pantay-pantay. Dumaan po yan sa masusing pag-aaral, lahat po yan ligtas at epektibo. Kaya nga po, ang pinakamabuting bakuna yung ilalagay sa inyong mga braso.
Interior and Local Government Secretary Eduardo Anyo released a statement, individuals will still be informed when they reach the vaccination site.
Sa araw mismo, pagdating nung individual, ay kung magtatanong siya, ay kailangan sabihin sa kanya dahil that's part of the rights of the patient.
If the recipient does not like the available vaccine, that recipient will have to wait for all the people in his category in his community to be inoculated before getting another chance to be vaccinated. Health Secretary Francisco Duque also underscored the importance of getting a jab right away over waiting for a preferred brand.
Anong pipiliin mo sa dalawa? Yung benepisyo ng COVID, yung benepisyo ng COVID vaccine, napakamataas. Ano? Yung risk, napakamababa. Yung benepisyo, anong benepisyo naman? Magka-COVID ka, wala. Pero ang risk, napakamataas. Ano pipiliin mo sa dalawa?
Local governments such as Pasay City backed the palace, reiterating that choosing and waiting for vaccines will slow down efforts to reach herd immunity. San Juan also wants to go by the Malacanang order for an on-the-spot release of information which can also be refused by the vaccine recipient. Mandaluyong City also stated that even before the DILG released its directive, it has decided to keep information about vaccine brands up to the last hour. Navotas City said it will send an appeal letter to the DILG noting that if overcrowding is the only problem, it can be solved through an organized way of scheduling individuals and prohibiting the entry of walk-ins. Adrian Ayalin, ABS-CBN News.